Once again, I would say welcome to our class today. You're highly welcome once again. So what are we discussing today? We are now in part 3 of our computer academy. And in this part 3, we're going to talk about the functional component of a computer. We're talking about functional component of a computer. What are we talking about? Honestly, we're talking about what computer is made up of, okay? So let's delve into the functional component of a computer and the central processing unit in detail. So without much ado, let's start with the first one. A computer system consists of two broad components, okay? Which is called the hardware and the software. Additionally, there are minor components that play specific roles within these broad categories. And what about broad component of a computer? Let's start with that one. Functional component of a computer, the broad component of a computer is the hardware. The first one, let's start with the hardware before we go to the software. Hardware refers to the physical parts of a computer system. And these are tangible components that you can touch and see. And you remember, I've discussed this before now. And it deals with the input device, which allows users to input data and commands into the component. So with that output device, like your monitor, your printer, your speaker, and stuff like that. Okay. You also have the processing device, which is your central processing unit. Okay. Graphics processing unit, GPU. Okay. And what is their function? Their function is to execute instructions and process data. And you also have the memory device. What is the function of memory device? Let's talk about example of memory device first. For example, you talk about random access memory, which is a RAM. So I have to talk about the cache memory. Okay. So what is the function? The function is to temporarily store data and instruction that are being processed by the CPU. Remember, we discussed this in detail at the beginning of the class. Okay. So those are the what made up the hardware component of the computer. There are so many. Talk about your keyboard, about your monitor, talk about your power button, there are so many. Okay. There are so many. Even your mouse, the screen you are seeing. So let's go to the next one, which is the software. Software refers to the programs and operating system that run on the computer hardware. And these are intangible and instruct the hardware on what does perform. So software, though you can't physically touch it, but it play a major role. We told the hardware what to do. Okay. So for example, you are using a mouse to click, and when you click an event, what you are clicking is a software that was programmed on what you are clicking. Okay, what is the example of a software? Operating system is a very good example. You come over, you press on your laptop, and everything starts booting. Those that are booting are the software component of a computer. Okay, like your Windows, your Mac OS, your Linux, and stuff like that. Okay, you also have the function. What is that function? They help to manage the hardware and software resources of the computer. Okay, so they bring us the application software. Example of application software is Microsoft Office, Adobe Photoshop, your web browsers. The example of what application software. So, if you have application software, what are their functions? They perform specific tasks for users, such as word processing, photo editing, and web browsing. Okay, we also have the utility software. A good example is your antivirus program, your disk cleanup tools. What is its function? Maintenance. Okay, simply put, maintenance. They perform maintenance tasks and ensure the smooth operation of your computer. So let's go to the minor component. We'll deal with the major component. So the minor component are those other smaller components that you can actually see. They fall into the larger component of hardware, okay? We want to break them down into smaller pieces, okay? Like your motherboard. What is the function of the motherboard? The main circuit board that connects and allow communication between various components of the computer. Yes, the mother, what do they call it? Mother. It's just like a house. It houses every other component in a computer. You have your power supply unit, PSU. What is the function of power supply unit? To provide electrical power to all the components of the also have your NIC, network interface card, NIC. What is its function? It allows the computer to connect to a network and communicate with other devices. That's why you can put laptop, and all of them communicate together. You send message from here to here, they move on, to be rewarded, okay? Yeah. So let's now dwell majorly on the CPU, okay? But before then, we also have your fan, your cooling system, like the fan, the heat, the sinks. What is that function? They keep the computer components cool to prevent overheating, okay? So let's talk about the central processing unit, which is the CPU and its unit. The central processing unit is the core component of a computer that performs most of the processing. It consists of several key units that work together to execute an instruction. The CPU example is your Intel Core i7, i5, AMD, Ryzen 5, and so many others. What is that function? To execute instruction from programs, perform calculation, and manage data inflow. Like when you make your Z to calculate, what's CPU to calculate? It's your central processing unit. Okay. We also have, let's talk about units within the CPU. You have your control unit that is present within the CPU. And what is its function? To direct the operation of the CPU. Okay. It fetches instructions from memory, decode them, and then execute them by coordinating the activities of the other units. Okay. Example is when you open a web browser, the central processing, the control unit, fetches the necessary instruction to display the browser and then manage user interface. Okay. So we also have the ALU. You've heard of ALU for some time now, I believe. Arithmetic logic unit. Okay. What is its function? Perform arithmetic operation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical operation, and or not. Okay. Example, when you perform a calculation in a spreadsheet, like Excel, the ALU carries out the arithmetic operation required to produce the result. So you also have the memory unit. Okay. What's the function of the memory unit? To store data temporarily for quick access by the CPU. Example is your memory, which is a RAM. Example is your DDR4, your RAM, your LPDDR5, and your RAM. Okay. What is this function? To temporarily store data and instruction that the CPU needs by performing tasks. Okay. It's volatile. What does that mean? It means that it can lose its data when the power is turned off. That's why I call it temporary. Okay, temporary. So don't use it for something that you want to be permanent. Example, when you run a program, it's loaded into your RAM for quick access by the CPU. So have the cache memory. By putting the cache memory, to provide faster access to frequently used data and instruction than RAM. Those data they're always using, you put on the cache. When you go there, you see it's immediately coming up. So you click on it, and it's open. Okay, so the CPU can retrieve it much faster than from the RAM because of if it's on the cache. Okay, so you also have the secondary memory. Example of is your hard drive, HDDs, solid state drives, SSDs. What is that function? They provide long-term storage for data and software. So if you want to save your work, you want to save your files, you save them on your what? On your hard drive or your SSD, okay? It is non-volatile, meaning it retains data even when the power is turned off. Even after days, you still come back and you meet your data. Example, your operating system and files are stored on the secondary memory, okay? So far, so good. Have we learned today? Now about the functional component of a computer. Talk about central processing unit. Talk about control unit. Talk about ALU, arithmetic and logic unit. Talk about memory unit. We talk about your RAM, your card memory, and the rest of them. Okay. So let's just take a look at the diagram to portray this. If you check, these are the component of a computer. Component of a computer. See, the central processing unit is there. The other ones is there. So you can go into Google, browse it, cross-check it, look at their names. There are so many. All the parts that make up a computer is your hard drive. You also know about your software, the application that runs your computer. Many programmers have programmed, the coders. You want to be a programmer, you also maybe you later on in the course, not this course, but other courses, you can join our programming courses and learn how you can actually code something. A computer will follow your instruction, give instruction to a computer. And the hardware and the rest of the computer will follow it strictly, says given. Okay, so you follow if you belong to that category, you fall into the software engineers. Okay, so if you can browse them all, there are so many can browse them all. I don't want this class to exceed 10 minutes, but I think the class trying to exceed 10 minutes. So let's call it off here and start the next topic. Okay.